Welcome to my channel. I am Priyanka Garaj and I will be taking your subject that is data science with Python. So the concepts of data science we will be implementing in Python. So it is very necessary for us to know that how to code in Python. So we will see first of all the overview of Python and the data structures. So these are the contents that we are going to cover related to the Python programming language. We will see the basics of Python. Then we will see the data types in Python, variables, expressions, functions, class and objects. And at last, we will see Python data structures and its operations. So starting with what is Python? Python is a popular programming language and it is used for machine learning, for GUI, for software development, and you can also make a web-based application using Python. So you can make different applications like desktop-based application also. You can also make web-based application also. And you can also make machine learning related, or we can say the data science related project by coding in Python. That's why Python is called as a general purpose language. So Python is interpreted. Why interpreted? Because most of its implementations executes instructions very freely and easily. In the different programming languages that you have seen, suppose I am taking the example of the C language, then over there we have to compile the code first and then we can run. But in Python, it is not the case over here. We can also make the use of the OOPS concept, that is the object-oriented programming concept. So in Python, we can write the codes related to the class and objects. So now the question is whether you can write the procedural-oriented code in Python or not. The answer is that yes, obviously you can write the procedural-oriented code in Python. So it depends on the what is the requirement of your application. So according to it, you can make use of the procedural-oriented code in Python, or you can also make the object-oriented code in Python. Also, the Python is a high-level language. So there are various multiple versions of Python available. Python 1.x version, Python 2.x version, and Python 3.x version. Since the Python 3.x version is the latest version since December 2008, so we will be using the Python 3 plus versions. The data science related libraries are present in the Python 3 plus versions only. So as I am talking about that, we will be using the Python 3.x version. So over here, we will be using for our implementation, that is the Python 3.7 version. I had already provided you the link to download the Anaconda. So that Anaconda version 2020, that is of your 2020, when you download it, then it shows that you are downloading with Python 3.7. So in Anaconda 2020, we are having Python 3.7 version. So in every programming language, the very first program that we study is the program of the Hello World. So over here also in Python, we will be studying the very first program in Python of Hello World. Now over here, this is my file name, that is the helloworld.py. .py is my extension of the file. So you all know that when you are programming in C and when you are saving that C file, C programming file, then what was the extension of the C file? The extension was .c. Similarly, when you are coding in Java, then when you are saving the file related to the Java code, then what would be the file extension? The file extension was .java. Similarly, when we are writing a code in Python, at that time, the file extension will be .py. So .py stands for the Python. What it will indicate? It will indicate that within this file, whatever code I am writing, that code is related to the Python programming language. So in our file, we will first print the statement, that is hello world. And to run this code, first of all, our first program we will run in the command line. So to run that program, our syntax will be like this, that is Python as the keyword space, then you have to give the file name with extension. So the very first program I will be writing in Notepad. So I am writing that print hello world like this, and I am saving this file. Suppose I am saving this file on my desktop. So I am giving the file name as hello world.pyxd extension. Notepad supports by default extension as .txt. So make sure that you have given a .pyxd extension. So I am saving my file on desktop. Now you can see that my file is present over here on my desktop. Now I want to run this file. So to run this file, first of all, we will open the Anaconda Navigator. So this is my Anaconda Navigator, that is the Anaconda 3. When you click on it, it will get open and you will get the screen like this. So my first box is showing the Anaconda prompt, and my third box is showing the Jupyter Notebook. We will be using the Anaconda prompt, that is our first program that we will run in the prompt. So I am launching this Anaconda prompt over here, and you can see that over here my current location is C drive, users and username, and my file is saved on the desktop. So I have to change my current location. So for changing my current location, I am using the command as the change directory, that is the cd command space, and I am writing the code as desktop, and I am pressing on enter key. So now my current location is on the desktop, and my file is also saved on the desktop. So now I can run my file. To run my file, what is the code? My code is like this, that is the Python as the keyword space, then I have to give my file name with extension, that is hello world.py, and I am clicking on enter. Then you can see over here my code gets executes, and in the output screen I am getting the statement like hello world. So what is this print statement? You have studied the C programming language. In that, there was printf statement. So what was the task of the printf statement? The printf statement's task is that whatever statement you are writing within the double quotes, that will be printed in your output screen. Similarly over here, this print statement is my Python function. So whatever statement you will be writing within the print function, that statement will be printed in your output screen. Now suppose instead of hello world, I am writing now hello all. I am saving this file, and I am again running this file over here in my Anaconda prompt. Then you can see that I am getting the output as the hello all. So this is our very first program in Python. So what is the extension of the Python file? That is .py. But we will not use this Anaconda prompt to run our code related to the data science. We will be using the Jupyter Notebook. So it is the web-based interactive computing notebook environment. So when you open this notebook, that is when you click on the launch button, then it will get open in your default browser of your computer system. So as it is the web-based, so it is open in your browser. But there is no need of internet connection when you open this notebook. If your internet connection is not connected with your computer system, then also your notebook will get open in browser. So there is no need of internet connection. So when I click on the launch button, my screen will look like this. This is my screen, that how it looks when I click on the launch button. So this is my Jupyter Notebook, which has opened in my Firefox browser for my computer system. My default browser is Firefox. So my Jupyter Notebook has opened in my Firefox browser. So this shows the list of different files. in my C drive. That is the desktop documents, downloads. So when you click on the desktop, then you will find the files related, the list of files or the directories which are present on the desktop screen. So you can see that when you scroll down, then all the files are related to the C drive. Now, what if I want to save, or if I want to save the file on my D drive or some other drives, or I want to see the list of files and folders related to the D drive or some other drives. So for that, what you have to do? So let's create our first notebook, and we will write a print statement in our first notebook. So let's see how it works. So over here I am having different drives. My D drive is already full, so I will be taking my E drive to save my notebook. So over here I am creating one new folder, and I am giving the folder name as notebook, like this. So this is my empty folder, and over here I want to save my first notebook. So this is only the list of C drives. So what I have to do, I will again click on the Anaconda prompt. Over here, what I will do, I will write E drive, that is E colon. If you want to use the D drive, then just write D colon, and I am pressing on enter. Now my current location is showing as the E drive, and over here I will write that Jupyter notebook. Everything in small you have to write Jupyter notebook, like this, and you have to click on enter, and you have to wait for few minutes. So what will happen, it will run my all the codes, and it will get open in my browser. So you can see over here my E drive has opened, and it shows me two folders. So I have created a new folder, that is the notebook folder. So click on the notebook folder. So these are the files related to the E drive. Now it is showing me all the list of files and directories related to the E drive. So I'm clicking on notebook, and my this particular folder is empty, and I want to create now new notebook. So on the right hand side, you can see over here the new button. So click on that, and it is showing the first option as the Python 3. So it create a new notebook with Python 3. So click on Python 3. So this is how my empty notebook looks like. So in this notebook, I will write my very first code, that is print hello world, like this. So this is my print statement in Python, and now I want to run this code. So for running the code, you can press above the run button, which is shown to you, that is above one. So when you click on the run button, the cell will get executed and the output is shown. You can see over here that the square brackets are empty. It means this cell is still remaining to get run. So now I am clicking on the run button. Then you can see that my output is just below the cell. So this is what my output is of the hello world. And this one shows that now my this cell has executed successfully. If you want to change the code, then you can write like this, that hello all, and you can also press the shift enter. So shift enter is the shortcut key to run the cell. So either you can press the run button, or you can use the shift enter. So now it shows as number 2. It means that this cell has executed 2 times. So it will show all the numbers in sequence. Now I want to save this notebook. This is very my first notebook. So I want to save this notebook. Before that, what I will do, I will rename my notebook. So it is showing me over here as untitled. So I will double click on it, and it is showing me the dialog box, that is the rename notebook, and I am giving the name as my first notebook, like this, and I am renaming this notebook. Now to save this notebook, you have to click on, that is Control S. Over here you can see that the last checkpoint is 2 minutes ago, and it is auto saved. Now I am clicking on Control S, then you can see the difference. Now it is showing that last checkpoint is a few seconds ago and you have saved your notebook successfully. Now open your folder, that is my notebook folder, which was previously empty, and now it shows my first notebook file, that is my first notebook, and the extension is .ipynb. So when you are writing a simple Python program, at that time your extension is .py, but over here you are using the Jupyter notebook, so your extension will be ipy, means ipython, and nb stands for the notebook because it is the notebook file related to the Python 3. So the extension is like this. But when someone asks that what is the file extension for the Python, then generally you have to tell that the extension is .py. But over here in this special case, we are using the Jupyter notebook, so the extension is ipynb. Now I can perform different operations in the notebook. So let's see. I am writing the code as input enter your name. So I am running this cell. So it is showing now the star. Star means the execution of this cell is in progress. The output is not shown yet. So over here, it is showing me the cursor. So I have to enter my name, and I am entering my name, and I am running this cell. So you can see that it is showing me the output. Showing me the output as my name. So what is the input function over here? The input function works the same as the scanf function in C. So what was the task of the scanf function in C? The scanf function takes the input from the user. So over here, when you want to take the input from the user, at that time in Python you have to use this input statement. Like this, you can perform various operations in Python. So I am writing 2 plus 3. You can also write subtraction, that is 7 minus 6. It gives me answer as 1. 5 cross 3. Then division also you can perform. Then over here you can see that in division it gives me answer in terms of decimal, but in addition, subtraction, and multiplication, it gives me answer in terms of integer. Now what if I want the answer of division in terms of integer? Then I also write 9 divided by 3, that is 9/3. It gives me answer as 3.0, that is the float value. Whereas in the addition and subtraction and multiplication, it is returning me the integer value. So when you want the integer value through division, at that time you have to write like this, that is the \ and your number, that is the 9/3. So what is this? This is the floor division, you can say, or you can say the integer division. So you, it will return the answer in terms of integer. Like this, you can also perform the various mathematical operations like 10 cross 3 divide by 2, and you can run the cell. So it is giving me the answer. You can, so this will perform the answer in terms of, it will execute in by using the concept of board mass, that is the multiplication division one. If you want that multiplication will get executed first, then you can also make use of the parenthesis, but make sure that it is very necessary to follow the grammar. When you are not writing any number after the operator, then it will show the invalid syntax error. So make sure that you are following the grammar properly. Now, if you want to make the exponent, suppose I want to do, that is 2 into 2 into 2 three times, that is the 2 to the power 3. Then what you have to write, that is 2**3. It means what? It is the exponent 2 raised to 3. So I can write 2 into 2 into 2 also. But what if I want a multiplication of 2 10 times? So I can't write that long. So you can write like this. That is the exponent part. This is the 2 raised to 10 like this. Next is the modulus. So what the modulus will give? It will give me the remainder portion. The division will give me in answer the quotient portion, whereas the modulus will give me the remainder portion. So this is what the basics about the Python is. In the next lecture, we will see that what is variables in Python, and we will move further. So thank you all.